High School media production team, and we're on the air with Fairview Basketball. I'm David Higgins, your play-by-play commentator. This is Cody Mitchell, my color commentator.
Hello, Fairview. What is going on?
And the film crew tonight is Tyler Tuttle, Travis Hall, Jacob Garman, and Yanni Parker. Tonight we're here for the Fairview and East Hickman basketball game. Your starters tonight for East Hickman are Douglas Young, Jameson Matney, Sterling Anderson, Brandon Tidwell, Jonathan Pack.
And the starters for Fairview are going to be number 10, Matt Hills, number 14, Bobby Bach, 34, Hunter Branch, 42, Stephen Ray, and number 50, Jason Flake.
Well, we're looking for a good game tonight, Cody, as we start with the opening tip-off. What do you think about tonight?
Well, Fairview's coming hot off their win last night, being their second win of the season, and this is coming home, so it is very crucial that they win this game.
Again, last time these two teams, Fairview won, so here we go for the tip-off, Stephen Ray. And East Hickman wins the opening tip-off.
That was number 4, Douglas Young, winning the tip-off. Give it back to number 10, Jameson Matney.
Matney taking the ball down the court. Looking for an open player, taking his time.
Bobby Bach trying to shut off the passing lane. Stephen Ray stealing the pass away. Hunter Branch back to Matt Hills, who's going to dribble it down the court.
He was trying to find an open man down low, it just wasn't there. Now here comes Matt Hills with the ball.
Looking for an open place.
He's looking for a lane, looking for a man, finds Hunter Branch down low. Hunter Branch looking for a man, finds Matt Hills at the top of the key. Matt Hills now with the ball, looking for a man. Finds nobody. Finds it, looking for a pass, finds Stephen Ray down low. Stolen by Douglas Young. Good steal by number 4. Here's number 10, Jameson Matney now coming down the court. Looking for an open player, trying to set up his offense.
Stephen Ray losing the ball has got to shape it up. We can't have this play, and especially not coming home. I mean, it's a packed house tonight, and they're trying to see a Fairview win.
Open look for 3 from number 10, Jameson Matney. It just hit off the rim and out. Here's Matt Hills quickly taking it down the court, looking for an open shot. Off the rim, no good.
It's just not there. Rebounded by number 14, Sterling Anderson.
Great rebound by Sterling. Sterling Anderson coming in for a shot real quick. Fouled on the shot, and I believe he'll shoot. No, it must have been a foul on Sterling Anderson. Must have been a charge right there. And so it'll be Fairview ball. Folks, excuse me on that last play. He must have traveled. I didn't mean to call him for the foul. Matt Hills now with the ball, taking it up the court. Walking, taking his time.
Looking for an open man. And that
takes it down the lane. Finds nothing. Stolen by Sterling. Sterling takes it up quickly down the floor. Stephen Ray trying to slow him down. Applies enough pressure to make him stop and take his time.
Loses possession there for a second, but manages to get it back and get it off to number 22, Brandon Tidwell.
Here comes number 10 with the ball now. Off to the 14, Sterling Anderson, 22, Brandon Tidwell, folks. Good job by Matt Hills to get the ball away from
Douglas Young, who just recovers it and makes the 2 points. And one thing that Matt Hills just stumbled over himself, but you really like to see that he can just find that open lane. If there's not one, he's going to make it. But he just couldn't pull it together on that one.
Great work by Matt Hills to try and stop the pass. However, Douglas Young made an outstanding physical play and got back in the play and just made it. Jason Flake down low.
Under to Stephen Ray, who goes up.
Pack
tipped away. Pack down by Sterling Anderson. Just throws his arm up and waits for the ball.
Here's number 10, Jameson Matney. Now back to over to number 14, back over to 24, Jonathan Pack, back over to 22, 22 up with the shot, air balls it, that'll be out of bounds.
Out of bounds, see the cheerleaders try to get away from that one.
Fairview's ball now, Hunter Branch to inbound the ball here. Here's Hunter Branch, Matt Hills now with the ball, taking a sweet time, walking up the court. 5 minutes left in the first half, with only the score being Fairview 0, East Hickman 2.
Fairview's hot off their win last night against Montgomery Central. Hopefully that'll be enough inspiration to get them going in this game.
Good job by Stephen Ray on the inside off the glass for 2.
Stephen Ray finally catches a break, and he makes it in, and it's good for 2. The game's tied up now, 2-for-2.
Jameson Matney continuing down the court. Hunter Branch and Matt Hill supplying the pressure. Back over to 24, good shot. Good shot by Jonathan Pack, banking it for 3. Your score, Fairview 2, East Hickman 5. Matt Hills continuing to take the ball down the court, trying to find an open lane or man. Decides to take it in himself, tries to find an open Bobby Bach. But great hustle play by Sterling Anderson, just trying to keep it away from Bobby. And makes a great physical play, and it'll be Fairview ball. Here comes Fairview to inbound the ball. Out to Matt Hills. Matt Hills looking for an open player. Good shot by Hunter Branch. Just didn't go in. Stephen Ray finds an open Bobby Bach. Bobby Bach for three. It's good. Count it. 3 points for Fairview. Here comes Jameson Matney to take it down the court. Taking his time trying to set up his offense, get them arranged the way he wants. Passes to number 24, Jonathan Pack. Over to Sterling Young. Back to Pack. Pack goes up. Tries to bank it. Just no good. That'll be Fairview's ball off of number, I believe that's number 22, Brandon Tidwell. Matt Hills now with the ball, trying to take it down the court, walking it down a little bit. Setting up his offense, trying to find something open.
There's a certain amount of heat amongst these teams, and there's definitely, the bleachers are full. It's fuller than I've ever personally seen. It's coming home night, so everybody's pulling out all the stops. Girls won their game, boys won their game last night. Hopefully they can keep this streak alive and beat East Hickman now.
Fairview.
Matt Hills over to Steven Anderson, back into Hunter Branch. Goes out to Jason Flake, who just can't keep control of the ball, and it's knocked out of bounds.
That'll actually be a travel on Jason Flake, and it'll be East Hickman ball. Actually, the girls team won last night too, so they're hoping to keep the three-game winning streak alive, heading into their games in the weekend against Marshall County. That's a makeup game for the games they missed last week or a couple weeks ago. So, and Marshall County is a really, really good team, so they'll be hoping to get those points. East Hickman now with the ball. Out to Anderson. Or Drew Elliott now.
Stolen away by Drew Elliott off the fingertips of Jonathan Pack. Giving it back to Matt Hills, dribbling down the court.
Matt Hills looking for an open player, trying to find somebody. Matt Hills up.
Matt Hills stumbles again. He's got to keep his game face on today or he's going to lose this game for everybody.
Now here is East Hickman to inbound the ball. Quick substitution. Here comes Ernie Franklin for Matt Hills. Ernie Franklin did really well last night coming in when Matt Hills fouled out.
I mean, Matt Hills just played phenomenally last night and until he fouled out and Ernie Franklin was forced to come in. But, I mean, I'm just not seeing it come from Matt Hills today.
Ernie Franklin, however, did a magnificent job last night. He made a lot of key free throws and made some critical points for the team. Quick three, no good. That'll be a foul, excuse me. And I believe that'll be number 22, Brandon Tidwell to shoot three. Oh, excuse me, folks, he'll not be shooting free throws. It'll be an inbounds pass. Finds a wide open player on the outside.
The foul was actually Stephen Ray committed, and he's got to keep that together because that was one thing he was struggling with last night. He's got the intensity, but he's got to know how to dial it back.
Foul by number four, Douglas Young on the play. Fouled Hunter Branch as they went up for the ball, and score is still tied 5-5. It's 2:35 left on the clock now in the first quarter. Ernie Franklin now with the ball, taking it in.
Looking for an open man, can't find it.
Tipped
Hunter
on the
Branch struggling to get the ball.
Tipped on the pass from Ernie Franklin, and now Drew Elliott actually steals the ball back for Fairview. Great job by Julia to keep the mistakes from happening. Ernie Franklin now with the ball. Finds Bobby Bach. Fouled by number 24, Jonathan Pack on the play. Refs have a quick discussion. Determined it is Fairview's ball. Oh, excuse me, they decided it's going to be East Hickman ball.
Foul again on Stephen Ray, and he's got to keep it together because he's going to foul out quick. He's got the aggression, but he just cannot keep doing these stupid mistakes. It's going to cost the game, and they got to keep a level head, keep their game faces on in this coming home game.
Steven has been very critical of the last couple of games. He's a great center, great job of rebounding, does a great job of scoring points in the paint. And it's critical that he stays in this game. Here comes number 22, Brandon Tidwell on the jumper. No good.
Rebounded by Hunter Branch, using his size as he always does, making him one of the best rebounders in the state. Out to Ernie Franklin, over to Bobby Bach. Fakes the three, gives it under.
Couldn't get it to Jason Flake. Stolen by number 24, or excuse me, that'll be number 4 or 14. Sterling Anderson, folks, excuse me. Jameson Madney taking it up the court. Finding number 24, Jonathan Pack down low. Stolen by Ernie Franklin. Fouled hard by Jonathan Pack, just trying to slap it away. 1:25 left in the first quarter. Score tied 5-5. Drew Elliott to inbound the ball to Ernie Franklin. Ernie Franklin takes a cool walk up to the half court.
He's just trying to take his time so his offense can get set up, give him something to look for.
Bobby Bach now with the ball, gets poked away by number 4, Douglas Young. It's going to be a good matchup tonight between these two players, Cody.
Back out to Ernie Franklin, can't find anything down low. Ernie Franklin trying to make his way through a hole.
Jonathan Pack playing a tight defense, doing a good job. Jason Flake now with the ball. Sees nothing. Finally finds Hunter Branch. Hunter Branch finds Ernie Franklin. Franklin back out.
Jason Flake, look at Jason Flake up under, can't get the pass off.
Jason Flake now down under, finds Drew Elliott. Drew Elliott for three. Good for three for range. That'll be Fairview 8, East Hickman 5. 30 seconds left in the first quarter. East Hickman going to try and get the last points in.
Jason Flake's really trying out there. He's got to redeem himself after he lost that pass. I mean, Fairview's just got to keep on their game. They don't look like they're on the ball tonight.
Air ball by number 24, Jonathan Pack. Ernie Franklin now with the ball as you hear the fans making number 24, Jonathan Pack, feel bad for Ernie by Ernie Franklin, just making him look.
Making him look stupid out there. Knocked him on his butt, didn't even touch him. Ernie Franklin, in with the J, knocks it in for two.
Right before the end of the half, great series of play by Ernie Franklin right there, folks. Jonathan Pack not having the greatest minute of his life right there, getting packed by or missing that air ball and then getting juked out by Ernie Franklin. Your score being Fairview 10, East Hickman 5, 8 at the start of the second quarter here. Two fouls for each team, so not too much foul trouble. Folks, it's been a great game, what we've seen so far. A lot of fans, lots and lots of fans. East Hickman has got a tremendous amount of people, and so does Fairview. It's more than I've seen in quite a couple of weeks because Fairview's they really celebrate their traditions, and coming home has been one of their pride and glories over the past couple of years. East Hickman only 15 miles away from Fairview, so they're trying to make it look really good for them. As we see an exchanging of shirts on one of the East Hickman players, trying to get ready for the game. So as we come back for the start of the second quarter, East Hickman trying to come back after that quick series of, after the quick 3-2 by Fairview. So as we come back out onto the court now, it'll be East Hickman ball. And that'll be Fairview ball, rather. Sorry, folks. Drew Elliott to inbound to one of his teammates. Drew Elliott with the ball. Finds a wide open Matt Hills, who has to do a little bit of work to get it. Matt Hills finds a quick and open player. Jason Flake on the rebound, puts it back in off the glass for two. Your score, Fairview 12, East Hickman 5. Number 22, Brandon Tidwell taking it down, finds number 14, Sterling Anderson. Anderson back out.
All the way around the world until he gets over to Jonathan Pack.
Who unfortunately travels on the play and will be a inbound for number 34, Hunter Branch. Matt Hill now. Matt Hill with the ball. And he slowly
trying
taking
to set up his offense, trying to set up his offense, give him something to look for outside to Bobby Bach. Matt Hill's going to run in and try to get the ball. Drew Elliott with an amazing three-point gets the ball. Matt Hills back over to Bobby Bach, who's wide open. Out, Matt Hills. Looking for an open man. He just can't find him. Defense is harsh on the Fairview High School basketball players tonight.
Matt Hills has a good spin move there. Bobby Bach out in the wide. Matt Hills now seeing what he can do to control this clock here, taking a sweet time to set up his offense. Finds out to Drew Elliott, who finds Jason Flake down low. Kicks it back out to Matt Hills. Matt Hills taking his time to set it up, trying to find an open lane to dribble through. Fouled on the play by number 24, Jonathan Pack, and it'll be Fairview ball.
And that's what I was talking about. I mean, Matt Hills does. He can drill through that lane, and he can make one if he doesn't find one. But he's got to keep control of that ball whenever he does that.
And they also got to have patience to see if that lane will open up and see if they can find something. Here's Drew Elliott to throw the ball back in.
Matt Hills was a huge difference maker last night. Let's see if he can do as well tonight.
Hunter Branch passes to Bobby Bach. Bobby Bach finds Drew Elliott. Tries to find somebody down low. It isn't there. Finds Matt Hills. Matt Hills dribbles it in. Kicks it out to Drew Elliott for three.
count. He makes his second three-point shot of the game.
Your score, Fairview 15, East Hickman 5. Great three by Drew Elliott. Two in a row for him. He actually had, before last night, he hasn't made one in six games, so it's very impressive that he's been doing this well.
Drew Elliott really has been a huge difference maker in this game, which, I mean, it's kind of unusual for him. I mean, he's a good basketball player, but he's not very standout, and it's really nice to see him coming to his own in this coming home game.
East Hickman just threw away the ball there accidentally, so it'll be Fairview's possession with 6:25 here left in the second quarter. Score still 15, Fairview 5, East Hickman.
We're going to go ahead and mention our halftime show while we're at a timeout. We're going to be interviewing the recently crowned coming home king, Devin Penner. He's going to be in the studio with us. So stick around for that.
Yeah, he was crowned in between games, between the girls' basketball game and boys' basketball game. He's a good guy. He used to actually play basketball last year, and he was a very good player, except he just found it wasn't his calling and just chose to stick to football.
He's had too much on his plate as a senior, and he's wanted to keep it to theater and football this year.
Also a very good actor, star in the upcoming play, Romeo and Juliet.
And we'll be asking some more questions about that at halftime, so you're going to want to see that.
All right, here's Fairview to inbound the ball. Refs hands the ball off to Hunter Branch. Hunter Branch passes it to Matt Hills. Matt Hills walking it up the court, trying to take his sweet time. Matt Hills finds an open lane, finds Juliet outside, trying to give him the ball since he's been on a hot streak. Drew Elliott now with the ball, hands it off to Bobby Bach. Quick, slips out Bobby Bach. Drew Elliott looks for the shot, it isn't there. Kicks it back out to Bobby Bach. Bobby Bach looking for a shot, finds Matt Hills, takes it inside, up for two. Count it. Good shot by Matt Hills. 17 Fairview, 5 and East Hickman.
That's what I was mentioning earlier about Matt Hills. I mean, he can just get through anything. But, I mean, there's a problem tonight with Fairview High School with hanging on to this ball, and they can't let that deter them from winning this basketball game. It's going to be over to number 22. Back under. Sterling Anderson, I mean, he is just a phenomenal basketball player. Very tall, been able to just block all of these. Doing an excellent job tonight on defense. Probably one of the tallest on the court. It's going to be Bobby Bach up for the three. Didn't get it. Rebounded. Passed out to number 24, Jonathan Pack. He's going to take it. Look for his open man. Swings it out. Looks under to Young. Up.
So the ball's going to be two free throws for number four, Douglas Young.
Fortunately for them, they got the pass off, so they're going to get the 2 points as well, tagged on to his free throws that he's about to shoot. If he can make these free throws, he can close the gap. It's a 10-point gap between Fairview and East Hickman right now, and if he makes these two, he could very well close that gap up a little bit more.
First shot is good by Douglas Young. Second
shot up, and it's good off the backboard.
Good bank shot from Douglas Young. Here comes Matt Hills carrying up the court.
Matt Hills dribbling, looking for his open lanes. Passes it over to Hunter Branch, who's wide open under to Ernie Franklin. Up for the shot, and it's good. Ernie Franklin doing amazing, just standout this game. Phenomenal.
Your score now, 19 Fairview, 8 East Hickman. Great job by Ernie Franklin. Great hustle, great speed, great shot.
And last night, Ernie Franklin's free throws may very well have been the saving grace of the Fairview High School basketball team. So, of course, the Coach Shipley's going to realize his skill and put him in a little bit more this game. And he's, it's doing him quite well. He's a huge difference maker. He's doing very well this game, as good as he did last game. Shots up, it's no good.
Open
could
three.
Could be rebound again by Ernie Franklin.
East Hickman keeps getting these open threes. They have got to make these. It's crucial that they're missing them. Great rebound by number four, Douglas Young. Kicks it out passes it over to Jameson Matney. Matney carries it up the court, looking for somebody or find a lane to dribble through. Young now with the ball. Matney. Good shot. No, not good. Drew Elliott trying to get the rebound, just isn't tall enough to get there. Good job by Matt Hills to intercept the ball. Taking his time, going to slow the pace down, keep that tempo to his liking. Hills looking for a pass, finds Hunter down low. Good pass by Hunter Branch.
It's going to be knocked away, though, by Jameson Matney.
Ernie Franklin now trying to defend him.
Swinging it around all the way across the court to number 25. Trey Arwood.
Arrowwood. Good shot by number 22, Brandon Tidwell. Just missed a little bit. Douglas Young on the great shot.
Up again, getting these open twos, but can't make the layups.
Foul by number 34, Hunter Branch. My bad, folks. That was the opposite way around. Foul on Hunter Branch. Hunter Branch inbound the ball.
Number 34, Dalton. By number 34, Dalton Moore for East Hickman. It's going to be inbound to Ernie Franklin.
Ernie Franklin carrying it up the court, trying to find an open player.
Ernie Franklin's done an excellent job of proving his mettle these last couple games. I mean, I am quite impressed with his performances. Under to Matt Hills, who goes up and misses the layup.
Although Stephen Ray gives him a good shield, can't make the second. Good rebound by Ernie Franklin. Ernie Franklin up for two. Count it.
He makes it. Good. Ernie Franklin not only doing an excellent job like he did last night, but showing a great deal of consistency, making almost all of his shots this game. He's a huge difference maker. And it's nice to see that coming from Ernie.
Your score, Fairview 21, East Hickman 8, here in the second quarter with 2:50 on the clock. Jameson Matney with the three. Count it. It was good. Nice. Makes it 21-11. Fairview on top of East Hickman. Ernie Franklin's going to take his time walking it up the court, trying to find an open pass or a lane to dribble through. Franklin, good dribble again. He must have walked on the play. That'll be a sub, putting Douglas Young back in for number 25, Trey Arrowwood. All right, inbound to Jameson Matney. Matney trying to find something, get something going for his offense. Fairview's up by 10, and it doesn't seem to be a turnaround for East Hickman soon.
East Hickman's not really, I mean, they're crumbling. They're falling apart. They're getting open shots. They're missing them. They're giving open shots to the Fairview High School. They need to strengthen on both offense and defense.
Good shot by Douglas Young. Just doesn't go in. Number 12, Dalton Fraser on the rebound. Just doesn't go in. And it'll be off of Fairview, East Hickman ball. Two shots for East Hickman for Dalton Frazier. He must have
gotten fouled.
That'll
be the second
foul
from Hunter Branch this game.
Dalton to shoot two. First one is no good off the back of the rim. You know, free throws are such a mental part of the game. I mean, your mind can really get out of it from time to time.
They really are, especially the pressure that these basketball players are under. It's not like just standing around the gym and shooting free throws. I mean, this is a real game. It's real. Home. It's coming home. Everybody's yelling at you. You got to keep on your toes.
Messed up pass. Bobby Bach tried to get it. It's just too low for him, and it goes out of bounds. Quick turnaround. East Hickman ball. Jameson Matney walking it up the court, trying to find someone open. Look at Sterling Anderson looking for an open pass. Fumbled by Douglas Young. Goes off his hands. It'll be Fairview ball. Hunter Branch inbound the ball here. Each of these players have been in such good physical condition. They each have lasted very long, and it's going to be crucial near the end of the game, isn't it, Cody?
Yeah, it is. And they just have the endurance that East Hickman doesn't seem to have. But East Hickman has a much larger roster, which means many more subs. But if they can't keep this offense and defense under check from Fairview High School, they're not going to come up with anything.
Here comes Matt Hills on the dribble. Out to back out, up, down low to Stephen Ray. Stephen Ray up with a jumper. No good. Stephen Ray, great hustle to get his own rebound. Puts it back, trying to find somebody. Hits it out to Matt Hills. Back again down low to Stephen Ray. Swings it all the way around to Drew Elliott, back to Bobby Bach. Again, out to Matt Hills. Matt Hills looking for somebody.
Stephen Ray does have very good aggression, but, I mean, you just don't see the consistency coming from him that you do some of the other players.
Drew Elliott now looking for someone to pass to. Good block by Jason.
Hands it off to Bobby Bach.
Bobby Bach looking for a man to pass to. Good handoff to Matt Hills. Matt Hills finding open Jason Flake down low.
Jason makes Flake it through coverage, makes a layup and doesn't get it in.
Jason Flake has gotten his own rebound two times in a row. Good at rebound by Sterling Anderson that time to keep it away from Fairview. Good effort by Jason Flake. Even though he didn't make those two, he had the effort to try and get it back.
I mean, he has kept the heart, the aggression. He got every single one of those, just tried to shove it down the throat, but it just didn't work out for him.
Here comes number 20. Number 14, Sterling Anderson on the layup. Good block.
Rebounded by Jason Flake again, trying to redeem himself.
Here comes Matt Hills now with the ball. Matt Hills walking up and down the court with 28 seconds left in the first half. This should theoretically be the last play of the half in this game.
Matt Hills holds onto the ball, either letting time tick away or waiting for somebody to get open.
Pressure from Dalton Frazier. Back out to Bobby Bach. Bobby Bach looking for something to find. kicks it out to Drew Elliott. 12 seconds left on the clock, folks. Matt Hill's looking for a place. Fouled by number 12, Dalton Frazier.
That's going to be an intentional foul, keeping them from running down the clock so that they can get the ball back.
It will be Fairview ball, 8.8 seconds left on the clock. It's going to be hard for Fairview to get a shot off really quickly. Drew Elliott to inbound the ball. It's going to be crucial where he throws it to because they don't have time. They don't have a lot of time. It's going to be have to quick pass, quick shot. Alec Wagner now checking into the game. Drew Elliott didn't have any pass open, so he had to quickly call a timeout. So we'll see how that affects them in the timeout situation later in the game. Smart, though, by Drew Elliott to save their team from turning it over.
It really was. In 8.8 seconds, I mean, you could make a difference. They could score another point. Might as well keep the 9-point lead. But, I mean, it's not that Fairview's been doing fantastically or just sparkling on defense, but, I mean, they've been giving East Hickman all these open shots. East Hickman just has not been able to close the deal on any of them.
It's been odd because in the very beginning of the game, East Hickman was playing outstanding, had great offense, pretty good defense. It was just playing extending. But then in the start of the second half, midway through the first quarter, it just completely changed. Fairview took over this game, and it just went Fairview's way.
They just don't have the endurance that Fairview seems to have. I mean, they've just been crumbling under this pressure and just haven't been able to keep control of this game.
Drew Elliott to inbound the ball, trying to find somebody open. He wasn't able to find one last time, so now he's looking for one this time.
Finds
Alec Wagner. Alec Wagner looking for some pass to. Finds Drew Elliott.
Drew Elliott diving, trying to keep possession.
Out by Fairview. It'll be East Hickman ball with 4.8 seconds left on the clock. It's going to be hard for them to score in so little time, though, however. So I don't know how it's going to be. Number 52, Dalton Lance to inbound the ball here. Quick pass, looking for a quick shot. 3 seconds, two, one. Oh, it was a foul right before the shot. Very smart of them. Matt Hills gave away an accidental penalty. 1.4 seconds left on the clock. It'll be East Hickman ball, and I believe they'll just pass it in. Yes, it'll be just an inbounds for East Hickman. Here's number 22, Brandon Tidwell, to inbound the ball here. Fairview trying to keep a shot from happening. 1.4 seconds left on the clock. Tidwell sees nothing. Out to Young.
Young up right before time expires and doesn't make the shot. He airballs it.
Excuse me, that was Sterling Anderson. Just wasn't able to make the shot. Coming up on the screen right now, folks, as you see, we have cheerleaders lined up to do their halftime performance. However, we folks are going to have Devin Penner here with an interview. We got a couple questions for him as we wait for him to walk into the studio. So, Cody, what have you thought of the game so far?
I mean, I don't know. They started out strong, East Hickman, but they just couldn't get it. They couldn't keep it together. They crumbled. They didn't have the endurance that Fairview had. And, I mean, that's what it's going to come down to in the very end of the game. I mean, Fairview's been making some amazing passes, making some amazing shots, especially Drew Elliott. I mean, I got to commend him on his consistency. And Ernie Franklin being a huge, huge important part in this. And East Hickman, it's not like they haven't had any options. They just haven't been able to close on them. And that's going to be a difference maker right there.
Yeah, apparently the halftime show we have for you today, folks, both the cheerleaders and the wrestling cheerleaders today have worked together for a kind of scene for you guys today. We are still waiting on Devin Penner down here in the front lobby, or in the
And as we wait, we're going to let you enjoy this performance by both cheerleading teams.
Hat. Devin Petter, folks.
Thank you.
So you recently used to play for the basketball team. How was it back then, and how do you think the team's doing right now?
You know, it's obviously been a rough season, even when I played, and how it's going now. It's just, you know, it's rough. Coaching changes and just a lot of stuff that is hard on a team in the coach's first year. And I think Shipley sometimes has a hard time understanding that and expects things from his players, which is, you know, it's fine. It's like natural to expect the best from your players at all times, but it's a transition for everybody. But I think, you know, they're improving a lot. You can tell by the way I feel like they're dominating East Hickman tonight. And I feel like last night they played pretty well against Montgomery Central, who had previously, when I played, beat us pretty good, and they ended up going into overtime and winning, which I thought was great.
Yeah. Now, Devin, I also heard you're Romeo in the upcoming spring play of Romeo and Juliet, so tell us about that.
Romeo and Juliet, yeah, that's coming up. We're performing March 16th, 17th, and 18th, and I am Romeo, so it's one of those exciting things. It's kind of one of the reasons why I decided to opt out of basketball is because I had other priorities that required a lot more of my time, and something I was willing to commit myself a little more to, because you know, Romeo, people think Romeo is just a easy character to get into, but it's, you know, I've discovered that he goes through a lot of like emotional roller coaster, so it's difficult, but I'm very excited about it.
So now that you're a senior, how have you felt your 4 years at Fairview High School has been?
My 4 years has been great. I've done a lot of things in my 4 years that people haven't done. You know, I set some school records in football this season, and then I got in the state record books in football this season, and just, you know, being named king and then getting the lead in the play, and just all stuff I've worked up to this year is, you know, it's been paying off, and it's honestly an awesome feeling to be able to do those kinds of things, and it really is, you know, a great feeling to have worked for those things and then finally seeing some results from that. And so, and I look back on my 4 years of high school as very memorable, and we'll miss it here when I go off to college, but, you know, hopefully I can go into college and have the same kind of experiences and love that just as much as I loved high school. And so I think, for, you know, advice for anybody who's a freshman listening, just live the 4 years. You know, people get caught up in a moment a lot, and it's kind of ruins things. And I didn't do that at all. I just kind of went with the flow of high school, and it worked out great.
So speaking of college, what do you plan on doing after high school?
Well, I'm currently in talks with about 10 different colleges about playing football in the college. So right now it's still a little muggy about where I'm going to play and where I'm going to go. I should know in the coming months once, you know, all the money kind of starts coming out, when they start finally saying, okay, this is all we're going to give you and we're done with that, you know. But right now I could still get some money out of these schools that I need, because college is expensive. So I'll be doing that. I'll be majoring in theater, most likely, unless, you know, I can get a good film program. I want to end up screenwriting. So it's one of those. College is going to be exciting. I'm not quite sure where. A lot of the schools I'm looking at are out of state. You know, I've got a school in Michigan I've been talking to about playing. I've even gotten word from some Princeton people that, you know, my chances of getting in at Princeton are pretty good. So if that happens, then that will be – it's probably one of the greatest things that will ever happen to me if I can get into a school like that.
That's very impressive, Devin. And we appreciate your time. We thank you for coming down here. So thank you.
Thank you very much.
Hi, folks. We're back on the air with Fairview High School basketball. And at halftime, we had a great halftime. Got to speak with Devin Penner, coming home king, and he was pretty excited about tonight's game. Cody, what did you think of the first half?
Actually, I don't know, but Devin Penner, really a great student all around. I'm sorry I couldn't be here for that. I actually, there was only two headsets in this room, so I drew the short straw. Anyway, as we come into the second half, I imagine that Coach Shipley's over there telling his team to keep it up. I mean, they've been very endurant this first half. I mean, excellent job, very endurant. Not, I mean, defensively could be a little bit stronger, giving up some unnecessary shots for Hickman, but luckily they haven't been able to close on any, but hopefully they'll be able to learn from their mistakes before they start doing that.
Definitely.
East Hickman, I'm sure, just trying to get a rest in. Not very endurant. Started out strong, but kind of faded off at the end. I mean, they really need to work on that.
See, Drew Elliott had a great first half. He got two threes right in a row. Great job by him as we get this second half started with East Hickman inbounding the ball.
Drew Elliott, an absolute all-star this game, something you don't really see very often from him, going six games consecutively without a score, except for last night, of course.
Here coming number 24, Jonathan Pack with the ball now over Sterling Anderson. Anderson with the quick shot, no good. Stephen Ray mishandles the rebound. Back to Anderson. Here comes Pack with the ball. Pack, quick shot, good for two. That makes the score 21-14. Fairview on top of East Hickman.
Matt Anderson, Hill. Very tall. I mean, Stephen Ray is very tall in his own right, 6'4", and Anderson is still even taller. So he's a very, very key player on this team, and you can see it by the way his skill and his height. They use it both. His size, just immense, using it very well.
Stephen Ray down low, getting fouled from the back by Doug. Oh, must have been a foul on Stephen Ray, backing up into Douglas Young on the play.
Stephen Ray cannot catch a break, and he's very aggressive, but he's the foul king. I've seen more fouls from him in these last two nights. It's just, he needs to learn how to keep that under control.
Here comes Brandon Tidwell now coming up the court. Passes over to Sterling Anderson. Anderson trying to make a move on Hunter Branch and Matt Hills. Pass it out. Packs it back to Anderson. Anderson looking for a shot. Finds nothing. Goes up. No good. Puts it up. Good work by Sterling.
Puts it back up. Using his immense size again, like I mentioned earlier, to get that rebound and put it back up.
Sterling Anderson, great work. Just trying to find the glass front in the paint. Great work to get his own rebound over Stephen Ray.
Anderson, easily the tallest player out there on that court.
Bobby Bach now passes it back to Stephen Ray. Matt Hills down to Hunter Branch. Hunter Branch goes up easily for the layup. Number 22, Brandon Tidwell tried to draw the foul, but just didn't work for him. The refs didn't agree with him, so easy two for Hunter Branch. Punched out by
Bobby Bach off the hands of Bobby Bach, so it's going to be an East Hickman throw-in.
East Hickman to inbound the ball here. Number 24, Jonathan Pack to inbound it here. As the East Hickman coach has a slight talk with one of the referees. Also want to thank our referees tonight and every night, Cody. We get a lot of they get a lot of negative attention, but really we got to thank them for what they do. That'll be a travel on number 22, Brandon Tidwell. Here goes Hunter Branch on the inbound to Matt Hills as we wait for a substitution. 6:11 left in the third quarter, folks. Your score 23-16, Fairview on top of East Hickman. Zero fouls in the first half, in the second half, folks. Here's Bobby Bach with the ball now. Over to Jason Flake back into the game. Looking for a player. Finally finds Bobby Bach at the top of the key. Looking for somebody. Finds Matt Hills. Matt Hills swings it around to Jason Flake. Jason Flake down low to Drew Elliott. Jason Flake gets it back. Great job to get up and get the rebound.
Jason Flake, very, very, very aggressive. A lot of heart, a lot of courage from that player. I mean, he's really got his head in the game, but he's not known for his ball handling skills, but he sure can get that ball, and that's what I mean.
He tried to get it right there, folks, but it just slipped out of his hands. Great work by Jason Flake. Number four, Douglas Young to inbound the ball to Jameson Matney. So Jason Flake, great kid. He's one of my friends. I don't know about you, but he's a great person.
Oh, yeah, he's a good guy. But, he's got a lot of heart. You can tell he really goes for that ball. But his ball handling skills just aren't really there. But, he makes up for it with his heart and his aggression.
Jameson Matney passes off to number 24, Jonathan Pack. Try to get the pass to Anderson. He's just fouled on the play. So that the foul will be on. Can't tell right now, folks. Foul, it will be on number 34.
It's going to be on number 34, Hunter Branch. It's his third foul of the game, so he's going to need to watch that two more, and he's out of here.
So at the timeout, Cody, what do you think the coaches have to say to each other?
They're going to tell, Coach Shipley, obviously Fairview's losing their grip over this game. Coach Shipley's going to tell him he's got to keep his head in the game. Coach Shipley, a very, very in-your-face coach. I love that about him. And the East Hickman coach said, keep it up. We're getting better. We're getting better. Just keep that aggression. Keep that endurance going.
Fairview now, or East Hickman with the ball now, looking to inbounds for a couple points right here. Fairview, I think, has got to keep up the pressure, keep up the defense, try and keep the East Hickman from attacking. And just kind of improve their game a little bit. Here's East Hickman inbound. The ball finds an open Brandon Tidwell in the middle. Just couldn't get the shot up, right? Here's Fairview to inbound the ball.
or excuse me, here's East Hickman to shoot two free throws. Foul will be on number
Matt
10.
Hills. Matt Hills. It was on Matt Hills. That was his second foul of the game. Not near as many as he had last night, so hopefully he'll be a little less risk of fouling out two nights in a row.
Brandon Tidwell to shoot two for the first time tonight. Little help from Stephen Ray. Second shot for Brandon Tidwell as he puts it up. And it's good. Count it. Score 23, Fairview 17, East Hickman. Matt Hills continues taking the ball down the court. Matt Hills trying to set up his defense. He's really been one of the crucial games this whole season for Fairview, and he's been setting up the offense all season long. And he's been doing a fantastic job. But, however, Fairview turns the ball over, and Jameson Matney now brings it back down.
It was out of the hands of Stephen Ray, who just couldn't maintain possession. I mean, he's not very consistent. He hasn't been doing very well. I mean, he needs to get his head in the game. He might just be cracking under the pressure of this coming home game.
Sterling Anderson has had a magnificent night tonight.
I mean, look at how tall he is. Barely even a jump. He could have reached up and made that shot.
See, he's made at least 10 points for East Hickman tonight. He's rebounded. He's stole. He's shot well. He's done everything for East Hickman. Without them, I don't know how they would do in this game.
He has. Stephen Anderson has just been a huge, crucial part, scoring over half of the points that they have to their name so far, and just closing the gap, bridging it between him and and Fairview.
Drew Elliott for three.
That would have been his third consecutive three-point shot after a six-game no-shot streak.
Hunter Branch foul on the shot. He'll shoot two. Foul by number 24, Jonathan Pack. You know, Hunter Branch, yeah, he didn't have so great of a game last night. He kept getting frustrated. His shot wasn't there. But this game, I think he's been doing a little bit better. He's been a good rebounder. He's fouled a little bit too much, but I think he's doing much better than last night.
He is, and he's a very, very, very good player.
Hunter Branch makes his first shot. Here goes the second. Second is put up. Misses off the front edge, rebounded by Sterling Anderson.
Very good rebounder, Sterling Anderson is. I mean, he just uses his size so well. He's so immense and so massive.
Number 10, Jameson Matney finds number 24, Jonathan Pack outside. Pack with a shot, good for two. That cuts the lead to three. Matt Hills trying to find something, trying to get this offense going. They just haven't found anything the last few possessions, trying to score some much-needed points right now.
Scored hardly any points.
Good fake by Matt Hills up to Bobby Bach. Great play by the two stars right there.
I mean, they need to keep that going. That's only their fourth point that they've scored. That's only 4 points in this half. And, I mean, East Hickman's just dominating this second half so far. I mean, they're bridging the gap really well. Now only 5 points behind when before they were 10.
Sterling Anderson's. Sorry, folks. Sterling Anderson trying to take it down low. Just wasn't possible. So that'll be East Hickman's ball in the inbound.
He was actually fouled by Matt Hills. Matt Hills got to keep those fouls in check. I mean, as history showed us, he's a big fouler, and can't let him bite in the butt later.
Three fouls already for Matt Hills. He already fouled out last night. Quick three by Jameson Matt, and he missed badly. Good rebound by Bobby Bach. Bach taking it up the court rather quickly. Finds Ernie Franklin. Ernie finds Hunter Branch down low. Branch kicks it back out to Ernie Franklin.
Ernie Franklin really been showing his worth in this last two games. I mean, he's just been an amazing, outstanding player. You got to give him props for that.
Douglas Young tips it away from Stephen Ray. Took him by the court by Stephen Anderson. Great tip in. Oh, good try by number 22, Brandon Tidwell. Just Bobby Bach pushed him out of the way. Got the ball back.
Stephen Ray just wasn't able to hang on to it again. I mean, not very good ball control coming from him. I think that he needs to sit down and take a rest, think about what's going on in this game.
Stephen Ray, actually, he hasn't been picking his head up. Hasn't been looking for those passes like I think he needs to. While we were talking, Brandon Tidwell just fouled number 34, Hunter Branch. Drew Elliott's inbound the ball here. That is Tidwell's first of the night, by the way.
He's going to want to keep that in check, though, because, I mean, those can come up on you really quick.
Here's Ernie Franklin to shoot. Here's Ernie Franklin on the dribble, looking for someone to find open. Ernie Franklin now the ball passed over to Drew Elliott. Drew Elliott looks for an open shot. Packed by, again, Sterling Anderson. Anderson having a beast of a night. He's just been unstoppable.
good foul by number 42, Stephen Ray. And on the foul, fans not agreeing with that, but I don't know how many that is for him, but he's definitely in foul trouble right now. He's already got three for tonight. He's got to watch that. As a big man, he can't keep getting fouls like this. They need him later in the game. Here's Brandon Tidwell to shoot two. Brandon Tidwell to shoot two here.
All right.
Here's Brandon Tidwell to shoot two. Rebounded by number 24, Jonathan Pack.
Makes his first, misses his second.
So here's Fairview's ball. Drew Elliott to inbound the ball here. .212 left in the third quarter right now. Your score, 26, Fairview, East Hickman, 22. Only four fouls for Fairview, three only for East Hickman. And as we speak, Ernie Franklin now with the ball, looking for an open man. Takes it inside, finds an open Drew Elliott. Drew Elliott kicks it out to Ernie Franklin. Franklin looking for a lane. Tipped out by Douglas Young. That'll be Fairview ball.
Actually, Ernie was going to be inbounded. Foul was going to be on Douglas Young. It's his third of the night. He's got to keep that in check.
Hunter Branch with a quick shot up. No good. Tried on the rebound by Jason Flake, but actually Douglas Young came up with it.
Grabs it right out of the hands of Jason Flake. Jason Flake got to put a little bit more effort into that.
Brandon Tidwell tried to get it, but it just didn't. But he was fouled on the process, so that'll be him shooting two. Here goes number 22, Brandon Tidwell, to shoot for two.
That foul was actually on Jason Flake.
His first of the night, so that's pretty good for the big guy. Only had one foul this whole night. Cody, what do you think Fairview needs to improve on? They've only scored 4 points this whole quarter. What do you think needs to change?
They need to strengthen up on defense. I mean, they didn't have the strong defense really the first half either. But, I mean, like I said, East Hickman's been able to come out and they've been able to close on the opportunities they just couldn't get a hold of in the first half. And they also need to get a little bit on offense because they're getting these open shots. He's open and they just can't get it. It looks like this is a completely different East Hickman team coming out here with the endurance and the skill that we didn't see in the first half. They've bridged the gap from 10 to 4 and now they're on the comeback trail.
Stephen Ray and Matt Hills, we need to talk about. They both are getting in foul trouble. They already have three each. That's why Coach Shipley has taken them out of the game. I do think they need to control themselves a little bit more. If they foul out, it could change this game drastically because both players are such impact players that they have that dynamic to just change the game.
Hunter Branch also with a good amount of fouls, and they're all such key players. They cannot afford to lose them in this coming home game, especially with East Hickman doing as well as they are.
And Fairview High School only have 10 players all together on the varsity team. They don't have a lot of subs, so being that, they can't afford to lose so many players. Brandon Tidwell to shoot two here on the play. Puts the first one up. High arc, good for one.
Spins around, goes right into the goal.
Here's Brandon Tidwell's second shot. Brandon Tidwell's second shot, good. That cuts deficit to only two. Matt Hill's now at the ball trying to change this offense for Fairview. Fairview has not been doing well at offense at all this third quarter. Finds Hunter Branch down low, tries to put it up, just isn't good. Douglas Young with another rebound tonight. Jamison Matney takes it up the court, pushes the tempo. Finds number 24, Jonathan Reed, down low. Back out to Matney. 22 now has the ball, Brandon Tidwell. Tidwell swings it all the way out to Jonathan Pack, who shoots three, no good. Ernie Franklin now with the ball. Ernie Franklin now taking it down the court.
Ernie Franklin looking for an open man. Takes it himself, trying to find a gap, but he just can't get one. Matt Hills trying to shuffle around. Jason Flake's wide open, looking for the pass. Out, swings it out to Matt Hills. Matt Hills up for the three, and it's going to come right off the right off the rim, up for the layup, doesn't go in either. One more time, and oh, that one's going to be good.
Good work by the player right there. Matt Hill is just struggling for that shot.
His effort did pay off in the end, and they've boosted it up to a four-point lead, but, I mean, they got to keep it more than that.
25 seconds left here in the third quarter. East Hickman's going to try and kill the clock a little bit and give them only time for one last play.
I mean, I think Fairview needs to realize that if East Hickman can bridge the gap from a 10-point lead, they're definitely going to be able to do it in a four-point lead. They got to keep on their toes and keep their heads in the game if they're going to get this done.
East Hickman making it two key substitutions, one for Douglas Young, the other for 24, Jonathan Pack. Number 12, Dalton Frazier comes in, along with number 25, Trey Arrowwood.
Also coming out is Hunter Branch for number 32, Alec Wagner. It's going to be his first time seeing any action this game.
Here to take the ball is Jameson Matney. He's going to look for an open player now. 10 seconds left on the clock. Finds a wide open Dalton Frazier at the backcourt. Frazier's can't make it. Jason Flake now the shot. Ernie Franklin
has 2 seconds left on the game.
Going to take a
puts it up. Right off the rim.
Only barely misses. Almost a three quarters of the court shot. That's a great job by Ernie Franklin trying to get a shot off. Cody, we're going in the fourth quarter. Fairview's holding a very, very slim lead. Do you think it's going to be able to hold up against this East Hickman team?
I mean, I don't know. East Hickman has obviously been able to show their mettle in this game. They've come out. They've bridged the gap from 10. They've really done an astonishing job this second half. And Fairview just needs to bounce back from this. They're wearing out. It looks like breaking down, like I saw East Hickman doing the first one. But 4 points is not a good enough lead against a team that could bounce back from 10.
Yeah, I definitely agree with that. Cody, foul trouble. Is it going to kill Fairview this game, or will it not?
Actually, Fairview's had a lot. They've got some close calls. Three for Steven Anderson, Hunter Branch, and Matt Hills. Matt Hills, of course, fouled out last night, so he's got a pretty bad history of that. Hunter Branch, a pretty big difference maker. Steven Ray just needs to dial it back just a tad bit on that aggression. All right, we're going to come through.
Here, back to start the game. East is going to be Fairview ball. Going to be Fairview ball now. Here's Bobby Bach to inbound the ball. Here comes Levi McDonald making his first entrance of the game tonight. Here comes Bobby Bach, finds Stephen Ray down low. Stephen Ray looking for a shot, gets it up off the glass and in. That'll be 30 Fairview, 24 for East Hickman. Matney taking it down the court now, trying to find something, some way to crack this Yellow Jacket defense. Great trap in the corner by Bobby Bach and Stephen Ray. Puts it up for three. Good shot by number 22, Brandon Tidwell. Puts it up and in for three. Levi McDonald now trying to take it in, trying to give Ernie Franklin a bit of rest. The freshman making one of his only entrances of the game.
Yeah, this is Levi McDonald's first time seeing any action. He's maintaining possession of the ball pretty well.
Hunter Branch going up for two. Doesn't get it, but is fouled in the process. Don't know if that was either Dalton Frazier or Brandon Tidwell.
Well, we're about to find out. It was indeed Jonathan Pack.
No, excuse me, it was Dalton Frazier. Here's Hunter Branch for the shot.
Hunter Branch is up, and his first shot is good.
Giving Fairview a 4-point lead. Here's Hunter Branch's second shot. He's been doing very well on his free throws. He's got a few this game. He's been doing pretty good.
His second shot is up, and it's good too. 5-point difference in between these two teams.
Here comes 24, Jonathan Pack now with the ball. He's going to try and get something started. He's going to try and rally his team around him and see if they can get this lead back. Again, East Hickman has not led since the first quarter of the game. The rest has been all Fairview. Great work by the freshman, Levy McDonald. Except that's going to be a foul on Levi McDonald. against number 24, Jonathan Pack. Obviously, the fans of Fairview not too happy with it. Folks, I mean, it just looked like he kind of just tapped him. That's the second foul, the first foul on number 12, Levi McDonald for Fairview. Here's number 24, Jonathan Pack, to take the ball down.
Jonathan Pack looking for an open man, open lane.
Puts it up for three, goes up the top, and if it's on the top, it's out of bounds. Hunter Branch to inbound the ball. Hunter Branch passes it in to Levi McDonald. Levi McDonald, only a freshman on this court. He's got to be a little bit nervous playing against a bunch of juniors and seniors. McDonald on the ball, trying to find an open man, finds Hunter Branch. Hunter Branch trying to find somebody, finds Levi again. Levi trying to direct his team around him. Levi trying to take a good spin move on the inside. Trying to find somebody, he's not seeing anything. Quick pass to Bobby Bach. Bobby Bach fumbles it a little bit. Bobby Bach trying to recover. Back out to Levi McDonald. Levi pushing the tempo, tries to hit it off of the opponent's foot, but it just doesn't work out for him. He's taking the ball. Jonathan Pack taking it down now, trying to find something. Shots up by number 25, Trey Arrowwood, but it's no good. And Stephen Ray again throws it away from Hunter Branch. Stephen Ray has got to quit making so many mistakes.
Stephen Ray needs to put his game face on. Hunter Branch obviously looking frustrated with the mistake.
See, Stephen Ray, he's not made some great decisions in this game. He should have passed a few times and said he shot. He's gotten the ball thrown away several times, and he's thrown the ball away again several times.
Pack taking his time, looking for a man outside, and the shot immediately coming off for Frazier. Didn't make it. Out of bounds. Bobby Bach is going to inbound it. Sterling Anderson tried to keep it in, but his size obviously just wasn't enough for this one. Hunter Branch is going to take it in.
Sterling Anderson, however, has had a magnificent game tonight, wouldn't you say, Cody?
He really has. I mean, he's a big guy, and he knows how to use that size also. Matt Hill's coming down the court, going to make a lane for himself, looking out and under. He's going to be knocked away by Sterling Anderson and Douglas Young, double team.
He was trying to thread the needle on that one. I just don't think it was there.
Jamison Matney taking his time. Swinging around for Jonathan Pack, looking for an open man. Back under.
Here comes Sterling Anderson looking for something.
Up, and it's off the rim. Can't get his hands on it. Stephen Ray knocks it out of bounds.
Stephen Ray, again, he's making several mistakes. I think he's just got to kind of get his head into the game because it's just out. I don't know where it is tonight. He's just not playing that well. He's knocked away a few balls. He's passed away a few balls, and he's just not made great decisions. East Hickman ball. Now to Brandon Tidwell. Quick three. Brandon Tidwell has been hitting many of his threes tonight. Quick pass to Matt Hills. Matt Hills gets fouled on it. That's going to be a travel by Matt Hills. Much of the Fairview crowd not happy with that. Neither is Matt Hills for the call. Here's Sterling Anderson to inbound the ball. Both teams looking a little tired, wouldn't you say, Cody?
They really are, but if I had to give an endurance award, I would have to give it to the Fairview High School Jackets because they have been able to keep on it more consistently. I mean, East Hickman has had some spurts of greatness, but I would have to give the consistency to Fairview, and that is going to be their endurance is definitely going to be their saving grace in this game.
Great steal by Drew Elliott. Hands it off to Matt Hills. Matt Hills coming in again for number 12, Levi McDonald. Hills looking for Hunter Branch. Great steal by Douglas Young. Passes it back over to Matney to try and take it down the court. East Hickman coach calling a timeout on the play. Fairview's defense has looked very good the last couple of minutes. Earlier in the second half, they haven't been playing well at all, but now their coach must have said a few words and they're playing a lot better.
Coach Shipley trying to keep this spirit alive, keep it going and keep a two-game winning streak, which would be the first time they've had a streak like that this season. He just wants to hold on to this lead. He looks kind of confident. He notices, you can tell by the way he's speaking, the the tiredness of the East Hickman team. He wants to keep his players endurant. And I've seen a basketball practice, and it is quite rigorous. They keep their players in shape, and that's for sure. And it's definitely paying off, and this is where you see that kind of thing happen.
Now, again, Fairview hasn't had the greatest season ever. They only have two wins on the season, one being against East Hickman at East Hickman the last time they played him. The other, again, coming last night against Montgomery Central. It was a great game by Fairview, one of the best I've seen in a while. And, again, going back to our interview, as we were with Devin Penner, Devin said last year Montgomery Central beat them. So, I mean, it must have been some improvement from last year.
You haven't seen it from Fairview, but they did show up. They did play last night. They really showed something that they haven't been showing all season, and maybe that's what's giving them this lead tonight, is keeping this keeping that spirit going.
Number 24, Jonathan Pack, with the ball now. Finds number 10, Jonathan Matney, out on the court.
Passes it back under to Pack. Pack goes up for the two and goes it straight over.
Hunter Branch gets the rebound, looking for Matt Hills.
I love seeing that from Hunter Branch. He uses the size. He's got the whole package. Heart, aggression, love it.
Great pass from Bobby Bach to Drew Elliott all across the court. Bobby Bach now at the top of the key, looking for a shot. Got nothing there. Great defense by Sterling Anderson. Matt Hills now at the ball, trying to find something. Tries to force it to Stephen Ray, just isn't there. Here comes Douglas Anderson. Dunks it on Stephen Ray.
And that is an excellent, excellent use of size by Sterling Anderson. Just, that was phenomenal. I mean, beautiful. That was pure poetry.
Douglas Young, great throwdown on the play. I mean, he just did it right in front of his face.
Douglas Young, what a good shot.
Matt Hills hustle for the play. Same with Stephen Ray. Possession will go to East Hickman, though, however. Good work by both players.
Jump ball. Stephen Ray does not look happy with what he just, the show he just put on.
It can't help that he just got ducked on, does it, Cody?
No, it really doesn't. Stephen Ray, he's got to get his game face on him. I know I've said it before, but, I mean, he's really got to get his head in this game.
Again, 2:50 left on the clock in the fourth quarter. Lead reduced 2-3. Fairview up 32-29. Fairview has 6 fouls. East Hickman only with 5. Coach Shipley's going to try and rally his team around Matt Hills, the star point guard, see if they can just get this game together. East Hickman fans also very fired up from that big dunk by Douglas Young.
They just got to keep this, all they need to do is keep this alive for 3 more minutes and they're done. And East Hickman, they need to, I mean, they could really win this thing. They came back from a 10-point deficit, and now we're only at a 3-point deficit. So, and with an amazing pump up like that dunk, it's very likely that they could come back and take this gold.
Number 24, Pack, to inbound the ball to number 10, Jonathan Matney. All the stars coming back in the game for East Hickman. They're trying to get their game back together. Sterling Anderson and Douglas Young have played outstanding games today.
Jamison Matney throws it under, makes its way all the way back to Pack, who shoots and it's no good.
Good hustle by Sterling Anderson.
Sterling Anderson diving into the crowd.
Taking out a few Fairview parents while he's at it.
Well, that'll be a nice souvenir for one lucky fan.
Here's Hunter Branch inbound the ball to,
Ernie Franklin.
Here's Ernie Franklin. Trying to waste some time, save his lead. Quick handoff to Bobby Bach. Bobby Hawk looking for something, finds Drew Elliott. Drew Elliott quickly pulls it up. Good
it's not
going
to be good. Excellent rebound, though, we have to say, by Brandon Tidwell.
Bobby Box trying to hustle down the court, get in front of his man. Passes up to Jamison Matney. Matney finds Pack. Pack goes in for 2. Gets it.
And it swishes in. 1-point deficit, and it's chaos in this stadium.
1:50 left on the clock. Not much time left in the fourth quarter. East Hickman trying to make an amazing comeback from 10 points down earlier in the half. East Hickman, got to give them credit for coming back. Foul by Sterling Anderson, number 14 on the play. Try to get that interception that they've been seeing all night from Bobby Bach to Drew Elliott. Again, it was Sterling Anderson on the foul. He doesn't seem too shaken up about it, but he was fine with it. That'll be his 2nd of the night.
Back out to Ernie Franklin, Ernie Fregley could just hold on to the ball, but he wants to get that lead so he can at least make it so the three-pointer wouldn't tie it up or win, for that matter.
Great work by Hunter Branch. Puts it up. No good.
No good. Drew Elliott coming in very aggressively.
Foul on Drew Elliott on the play. Brandon Tidwell will get the foul called for him.
Devin Penner, we just saw, doesn't look too happy. We interviewed him, and he is very, very school-spirited. One coming home king, so you know he's got to be Mr. FHS.
Shooting one-on-ones now for East Hickman is Brandon Tidwell. With this shot, he ties the game up at 32. With the next shot, East Hickman will have come back successfully from a 10-point deficit.
Especially since they're on bonus, which does not help out at all.
Here's Stephen Ray with the ball up to Ernie Franklin. Ernie Franklin now with the ball. Passes out to Bobby Bach, that would be Matt Hills. Matt Hills taking it in, gets denied by Jonathan Pack on the play. He'll shoot two. Matt Hills will shoot two. He's been a fairly solid free throw shooter.
And now both teams are on bonus, so that will actually help out Matt Hills in this situation. These free throws could very well save them from this defeat from East Hickman. I'm coming home with all these people coming out to watch this.
Matt Hills with the first shot. Good.
It's good. Fairview gains back the lead.
Again, your score, Fairview 33, East Hickman 32. East Hickman playing a great job of coming back from a 10-point deficit at the end of the first half. Matt Hills for the second. And he made it. Money for Matt Hills. Makes it 34 Fairview, 32 East Hickman. Quick comeback by Jonathan Pack. Ties the game back up in less than 5 seconds.
Gets over. 1 minute left. Fairview just want to try to get one shot off before they finish this. Matt Hill's holding onto the ball, trying to waste just a little bit of time before he goes for the shot.
Matt Hills almost throws it away in the backcourt. Drew Elliott now with the ball.
45 seconds. If they can't score here, we'll look at some overtime.
Fairview coach, Coach Shipley, wisely making a call to call for timeout, trying to get his team controlled under, keep them calm under pressure.
Coach Shipley, I'm sure, is just absolutely surprised, just dumbfounded as I am in the booth, that his team could be winning by so much and just lose it all so late. So now it's tied up 34-34. And we want to go ahead and take this opportunity to remind you that this production is brought to you by the media team. Tyler Tuttle, Travis Hall, Jacob Garman, Cam Jones, Yanni Parker, myself, and David Higgins, my PIC. Not to mention Bob King, the director, and he's the reason all this is possible.
Again, this is a Fairview High School media production. All right, Cody, what do you think the East Hickman coach is telling his players right now?
I mean, they got to get this 2 points, but I think they're happy with just the tie, because if they can go to overtime, that was better than what they were looking at in the first half. First half, they just looked down. They just looked out. They were tired. They were done. I mean, and now they've just been they've been revived, and it looks like it's a different East Hickman team playing.
East Hickman, I think if they do go to overtime, I have to give the advantage to East Hickman. They have such good momentum going into that. Here comes Drew Elliott to inbound the ball with 40.3 seconds left on the clock. Your score tied at 34. Matt Hills with the ball. Taking it, trying to figure out what he's going to do on the play. Kicks it out to Bobby Bach. Bobby Bach now with the ball. Trying to find an open player. Trying to take it back in. Finds Matt Hills at the top of key. 24 seconds left on the clock.
Quickly realizing he cannot dribble it around Sterling Anderson with such long arms and such a tall body.
Bobby Bach now with the ball. It's just been kind of switching between Matt Hills and Bobby Bach. Reach in by Sterling Anderson. Matt Hills will shoot two. Not a smart foul by Sterling Anderson. Actually, folks, I don't know if that was a foul or not, if they may have called timeout before the foul.
Fairview's got 12.5 seconds left on the clock, Cody. Do you think they can make score some points here?
I mean, if they can, it'll be astonishing. If they can't, we'll just go into overtime, and we'll see how that plays out. Either way, I mean, either team could pull away with this. 12.5 seconds, as we saw earlier, for the East Hickman team is nothing since they scored in less than five.
Fairview fans getting on their feet cheering for their team as we go in the dying seconds of the fourth quarter. Coach Shipley trying to draw up an offensive scheme here. Fairview breaks it down, comes out of the huddle. They'll see what they can come out of it with.
So much pressure. Both teams feeling the intensity, feeling the drive from this.
Drew Elliott to inbound the ball. Fairview's going to look for a quick shot, quick score. The unsmart thing for East Hickman would be to not foul. They cannot foul on this drive. And they do on the play. Great job by Matt Hills to draw the foul. Don't know on who, but it was a great job by Matt Hills. He has been absolutely rock solid from the line tonight. Let's see if he can make two to seal the game for Fairview.
That was actually Jonathan Pack, and he'll be out of the game. That was his fifth foul of this game, and he's out of here.
That's very bad for East Hickman, because if Matt Hills does make two his shots, then Jonathan Pack would be one of those players that you'd be want taking the three-pointers.
Yeah, you'd want him on your team in a tight game like this to finish it out and maybe get that 5 second score back he just did.
Jonathan Pack again having a great game. Matt Hills for the game is going to try and make these two shots. Coach Shipley deciding to make a timeout here, trying to calm his shooter's mind, reassuring him that he's going to make the shot, trying to make sure that he doesn't miss. And again, the other coach for East Hickman is going to try and make sure his players, in case they do score, to quickly get the ball and go score. So, Cody, what's the final outcome of the game going to be? Guess the score.
I mean, Matt Hills is a very, very consistent free throw shooter, so I am confident that he will make these. And if he does, it'll be on the shoulders of the East Hickman team to answer back with a shot or even a three-pointer to win the game.
Listen to these fans, folks. Both are on their feet. Both are clapping. Both are cheering, trying to get their team to win.
I am almost as certain as I can be that they will take the lead here. It's just the question, will East Hickman answer back?
Now, Cody, with this assurance, don't you think you jinxed them a little bit?
I mean, I don't know. Knock on wood, but I don't want to ruin their chances. But East Hickman does have a very lively shot, and Matt Hills is a very, very consistent free throw shooter, so we'll see what happens here.
Again, two most important free throws of the night for Fairview. And for technically the whole game.
This could be it right here. 7 seconds left, folks. Tied up, and we're in free throws. This is the kind of game you love to watch.
First shot goes up. Count it good.
Fairview will take the lead. The question is, will it be a one-point or a two-point lead?
35 to 34 Fairview right now. Matt Hills to shoot his second. He just looks calm as he could ever be, looking like he was just another day at the job.
Like I said, Matt Hills does have the consistency to make these.
Misses the second. Good rebound by Sterling Anderson. Anderson looking to take it up the court. Trying to find.
Time ticks away. 2-1.
Foul called on Matt Hills. That'll give a shot to East Hickman. Not smart of Matt Hills to give away the foul. Now East Hickman will shoot. Question is, will Jameson Matney find the coolness to make these two? With 1.2 seconds left on the clock, it's make or break time.
East Hickman coach is going to call a timeout, and this is the kind of game you just love to watch as the fans shuffle over to see what's going to happen.
All the fans are trying to get over the other side of the court, trying to cheer them on, trying to get this kid to miss his shot. They're all going to scream at him. They're all going to cheer at him. Look at the East Hickman fans getting mad at the Fairview fans for crowding the side of the court. Fairview fans are going to try and get in Jameson Matney's head. I would not want to be Jameson Matney for the world right now.
It's hilarious to watch because you see these Fairview players just kind of kick the cheerleaders off. And Ricky Jones coming over isn't going to allow it.
kicking them back on the bleachers. East Hickman fans also not too happy about it, although every single fan is jam-packed on the left side of the stadium. Jamison Matney, most crucial 2 points of the game.
Jeez, they're pretty loud people. I wonder if you can hear us over them.
I mean, folks, it doesn't get any bigger than this. It's make or break. It's do or die. It's game or no game. Right here, Jamison Matney, first shot is up.
Just trying to zone it all out. It's up.
Misses.
It's no good.
First.
That's it. Hold on to it. That's the end of the game.
Hunter Branch gets the rebound. That is game.
Two-game winning streak makes a win in this coming home game. Excellent. Fantastic job. That is the kind of game you just love to watch. The fans take the court. I am astonished. This is fantastic.
Hunter Branch makes the game-winning rebound and wins the game for Fairview. Jamison Matney cannot make the final free throw. Obviously, East Hickman fans not too happy. Neither are the players. Great job by the Fairview team. Obviously, great game played. Great overall performance for the day.
Well, we're done here today, but we want to go ahead and thank the media team.
Yeah, thank the media team again. That would be Tyler Tuttle, Travis Hall, Jacob Garman, Cam Jones, Yanni Parker, myself, and my co-partner, Cody Mitchell.
Yep, yeah, see?
And, folks, great game. Feel sorry for East Hickman, but that'll be Fairview on top.
And although East Hickman did lose, you got to give it to him. They were on a comeback trail. It was a very close game. 10 points down, comes back, and almost wins.
Great game. Great job. We'll see you next time. 35-34, Fairview on top of East Hickman. This is a Fairview High School media production, and this is Fairview Basketball signing out.